Getting ready, warming up. And Bill Ross.
5 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, the American to win gold in the 1992 Olympic Games, center of the world, welcome the undefeated pride of East Carolina.
A bonus, a new car, a new... Not bad at all. And De La Hoya goes right to work.
One of my kids went up against him as amateurs. This kid has always been composed. He had a left hook at 13 years old that would have knocked down in the bed. So De La Hoya was a left-hander. That's right. Oscar, he's got a tremendous trainer in his corner. He's got Robert Alcazar. And I want to stress Steve Little and Robert Middleman. And Oscar, really, these are, you know, very small fights for that mountain. He's up there for a month at a time.
Oscar said he was very happy to be able to fight not only here, but in prospect for him tonight.
Exactly. Some of the great stuff we used to love as youngsters were watching the fights. The Olympic Auditorium on local TV. And this is a real treat for the fans at home. This kid is something special here, Oscar De La Hoya.
De La Hoya moving in to trade with Oscar. It was his plan, Joe, to try to back up Oscar De La Hoya tonight, but that game plan is not being born,
which was to come at De La Hoya. And you can make a monkey out of him. Every punch, and Nunez is thrown, and De La Hoya will come to the end of round one.
Nunez's opponent tonight in the black trunks. De La Hoya 9-0, Nunez 10-4-3.
Alcaraz told him to, Alcazar, I'm sorry, told him to go to the left. All about his upside.
Nunez, as he came off the ropes, they landed a left hand by Nunez, who was making,
De La Hoya is,
looks to rush in at De La Hoya, trying to land a couple of punches, and he's off a short chopping shot by De La Hoya.
Oh.
Another left hook by Oscar De La Hoya.
He's starting to find a way. Let's see if he needs to do it.
He's got Nunez backing up, looking for that shot. Nunez ducking under a right. He's lost his last two fights to Todd Foster and to Ricky Clive, but those are both.
He's a kid and dangerous and close with his head.
Some good defensive work. He's getting out of the way. Punches up.
De La Hoya coming forward to a conservative man. He does punches in his face. Up with late and a fair swing, not unintelligently. He's got to be smart about it.
That's the mere effect. Firing off a salvo and backing off.
Is he going to run? That's right. When I would say you went to Oscar De La Hoya, it was probably one of the hardest guys in the world. It's square. Step up, drop the right hand to the body, lift with the left foot. Here's Oscar pressing in.
The special boxing event, and always bearing the brightest, shining, upcoming star in the world of boxing. Trying to add to his stand the hard judge.
Just what, Rich? Is he 20 yet? And I know Robert Middleman and Steve Nelson, the two managers, four managers. They know what he's going to learn is he's going to probably have to hit Nunez. And the most he can do is try to be a little bit more patient, not less defensive, so you can do a little bit more
practice side. There's a quick combination.
Took it and he came back and gave De La Hoya a good headbutt. And there's the result of it. His eye is just open. This fight is not going to be a nasty cut right over the eyes of
it. It's the left eye that was blown wide open. I didn't see a fight. I saw a right hand come immediately after that. That's when I saw the fight fly out. But just on the head.
That was definitely caused by Nunez. He came in, dangerously with the head early. He's at a disadvantage with De La Hoya. And he got one eye. You're in big trouble.
And even here, seeing the blood in front of him is not half the deal. He's trying to line up his man, and even now,
there was an exchange here. Good left hook, and Nunez came out of that crouch with a head right. Here we go, let's see what happens.
The fight is over.
The fight is over.
The fight is over. They have called it that cut's just too bad, apparently. I did see his undefeated record with the book.